Welcome to the course for HR Dynamic HR Dashboard. Now, we will be talking about in this entire course about how to prepare the dashboard. Let's understand the concept of dashboard first. So, dashboard is basically the way to represent the data, what is happening with the different matrices. Okay. So, whatever the output of the matrices are there or the information related to different matrices are there, that will be displayed in the HR dashboard. So HR dashboard will be basically, it should contain the number of employees or the employees that are there working with different verticals, about the different diversities of the employees, whether they are male, female, the number of employees that have joined with the recent years, the compensation related data, the data related to training and development, the data related to attrition, the data related to, risk of leaving of the employees of the for the organization. Okay, now this information, risk of leaving the organization, is derived from the HR analytical function. Okay, rest are basically where the information that we gather. Okay, so entire work that we'll be doing right now, okay, will be based on the dummy data that has been prepared especially for this course. None of the data has got any relevance with any organization as such. So it is totally a dummy data. And on the basis of that dummy data, we will be preparing the dashboard. Now, as we know that the dashboard should contains the various information, it has been seen many people looking forward for different dashboard that need to be prepared by the organization. So the dashboard differs from organization to organization. The dashboard differs from industry to industry. Okay, it depends upon the work that you are planning to do. It depends upon the kind of industry that you are dealing with. It depends upon the requirement of the particular dashboard. Okay. So, or the organization or the industry may or may not have the same kind of requirement related to information related to a particular dashboard. So whatever the dashboard we are actually will be designing is basically on the basis of requirement. Now, as there is no standalone, I will not suggest that there is any standalone HR dashboard for HR. The dashboard may differ from organization to organization. And that organization to organization dashboard is because of the information that is required. Okay. So dashboard should reflect the information that is required, but on in general, all the dashboard need to have some information that is related to the employees data, number of employees in which department, number of employees, whether they are, on the basis of, contract appointment, regular appointment, or any other form of appointment. Okay, or on the basis of different diversities related to whether they have been posted in different locations. Okay. And then gender diversity need to be covered. The attrition rate too need to be there present in the dashboard, because this is information is very vital for any organization. Then training related information related to compensation, some data related to compensation, because all the data related to compensation cannot be placed in entire dashboard. And related to whatever the, joining in particular year is there. Okay. So, there are two part of that. One is that HR dashboard, and one is making a dynamic HR dashboard. Now, when we are talking about dynamic HR dashboard, it should actually be connected to some platform, tool, so that whenever we change some certain data, okay, the information get updated. At the same time, dashboard should be dynamic in the sense that if when the year is changing, for example, we are recording this video, if we are recording this video on the month of September 2020. Okay, so when we are recording this video in September 2020 and we in January 2020, some people joined in the month of September itself or in the month of October. So the number of joining should increase, and the number of employees in a particular division or a particular location should automatically increase. We should not go and calculate the numbers again and again and do the make the dashboard and send it the report to that. It should be dynamic and work by itself. The calculation should do by itself. We will be using HR dashboard, making the HR dashboard in Excel itself, because Excel is one of the tool that is used in most of the organization, and almost all people use the HR Excel as one of the important tool for making doing all the calculation or keeping the data. So we'll be using the HR dashboard. Now, when we are coming to the dashboard, the general dashboard that we can expect is basically what we call as the text-related representation of the data. Now, the information in the text-related data is also more or less the same. Okay, so we have, say, for example, on the basis of the dummy data that we have been prepared. Okay, so we have got, say, active manpower details related to, say, how many people are there in contract, regular, HO absorption, bond, and so on. Okay, and then we have in the different departments. Okay, and departments, we can have the compensation related information, and then we can also have the information related to HODs. Okay, and then the employment related to which of the department. Now, all this information in the form of text representation is actually very good. It seems to be very good, but at the same time, it looks working on the Excel sheet itself. When there is in some graphical representation, it looks nice. Okay, and it's also looks nice that when it is being prepared for any other person to visualize. So there are basically, when we are talking about the dashboard is of two type. Okay, I would suggest all HR professionals to make at least two dashboard. One should be that is requiring the HR's functions, okay, related to all data is related to HR. And at the secondly, I would like to all HR professional to work on the employees HR dashboard. So there should be a dashboard for each and every employee. Now, when we are saying that we will be requiring each and every dashboard for each and every employee. So if there are 500 employees in the working in the organization, you may expect that there should be 500 different sheets of Excel in the workbook. Okay? But that is actually not happening. And even if we make 500 different dashboard, it is not actually doing the function that is what we are calling as the dynamic HR dashboard. Okay, so this is basically the representation, small representation on a dummy data. Okay, during the entire course, I will be helping you making your own dashboard. Okay, so those there are number of times happens that people look forward for HR dashboard asking in WhatsApp or Facebook or LinkedIn from other person. Now this the purpose of this course is that you will be able to design your own HR dashboard. Okay, and that dashboard you will be I will be just guiding you to the process. You will be having your own data. You need to do practice this thing, and then slowly, and then you can design much better dashboard according to your requirement, according to that what is suits to you. Okay, so this is what we call as the graphical representation of the data. So we have got 442 active employees in the organization, out of which 20 employees are there in the contract, and 402 employees are there in total regular. Now this regular contents of regular employees, HO absorption, and some employees are there in the bond. Again, I will say that these are the dummy data. So just randomly generated data. Okay. So many times you will be seeing that the values are keep on changing every time we refresh, because this has been generated by a randomly generated number. Okay. And then there are that some people are working in the head office, some are different in the branches office and the site. Okay, so all the information related to whether the employees are related to contract, because this is the total manpower, active manpower. Okay, and this the composition of this manpower is for that kind of type of employment. We have got this, and on the basis of location, they have been this. And then we have the demographic details related to information related to the employees. So there are 398 male employees and 14 female employees. Okay, then this particular data shows your total attrition that is happening. Okay, so for different year. Now, when we are talking about dynamic dashboard, the you see here that we have got 2017, 2018, 2019, 2020, and as this video is being recorded in the month of September 2020, okay, the information related to 2020 is only available till the month of September. When October, November, and December will come, this value number of employee may be leaving the organization or may not be leaving the organization, or there are people who will be joining the organization or not joining the organization. So accordingly, this will be updated. And in 2021, this automatically there will be a display of 2021 here. Okay, and then we have got the attrition related to 2021 will be displayed, and accordingly this particular chart will be keep on updating. So in 2017 18 19 20 21 22 and till 26 27 we can add on that. Okay, now this is an automatically calculated system, so you do not need to do the calculation of the attrition rate again and again. Okay, and on the basis of whether they are voluntary or involuntary, we can understand. Okay, so we can see when the voluntary is there are people leaving the organization because they are actually retiring or their contract is getting expired, and voluntary are basically those employees who have left the organization by their own will. Okay. Now this particular information that you see here, so this particular information that you see here is basically the details related to training. Okay, now we, on the basis of training, we have got some information related to we have got this achievement. Okay, so achievement can be a certain percentage. That this particular, you know, you always need to remember that all the details related to this particular function is there in the matrices related to training. Okay, now the dashboard is not a matrices, it's basically the representation or the data being coming from different sources. Now the data from the matrices of the training, we know that there is certain percentage of the training that has been, you know, given as the target, or the total percentage that has been decided by the HR department or L&D head or the HR head of the organization, and then we do the training. And then we have achieved this training, okay, to a certain position. If it were not, then we can divert it into, say, 50% is poor, 60% is good. If I go up to 90%, okay, then we can have a very good. And then the target has been fixed at 90% level, okay, so that if I achieve this, I achieve this target. So this particular dashboard by itself shows that how much target have been achieved. So this is basically what we call as the bullet chart. Okay, so for if you want to go on work on different charts, you can go to Edusri courses on data visualization on Excel. Okay, and then there is the information related to employees who have joined. So in 2020, the 10 employees has joined, and in 2020, 14 employees have left. Now this particular data will be also updated accordingly. So the moment we enter into 2021, it will be reflected here as 2021. Now the number of joining and the leaving will be updated accordingly. And then out of this 442 employees, we know that there are 33 employees that has got flight rate of very high. So we need to work on those for 33 employees. And then we have got 53 employees at high. Moderate is 65, considerable is 271. So this particular data that we are having, so we know from this the data itself that we have to work on this 33 employees. Now this 33 employees will be there, so we need to go to the particular data and search it out where it is very high, and then we start working why it is there. And HR analytics actually helps us in identifying the different measures, the different variables on which the flight rate has been decided. Then we have the data related to the compensation. Now we see on the basis of the dummy data that 31% of the total compensation paid by the organization, okay, is going to the electrical department, then civil department 14%, design and engineering department 14.72%, mechanical 13.6%, and so on. Okay, so we have got all these data related to compensation distribution. Now this is the dashboard, so it shows the information here are arranged in a small order. Okay, not all the informations are there, but yes, your information related to when making a particular decision is available here. Okay, so during the entire course we will be working on different aspects of that, preparing the data, understanding the dummy data, because we will be using the dummy data, so we need to understand the dummy data. At the same time, we will be without using Visual Basic application or any other programming, just using the normal Excel function, how can we enable it to be more dynamic? Okay, how can we just without going and entering into the master data all the information, can we have some forms where we can just put in the data or edit the data, and then that data keeps on updating itself. Okay, so we'll be working on all the processes on how these things works on. Okay, now we can have the employee related data. Okay, now as I have said earlier, that if I have over 500 employees, you might think that we need 500 different worksheets. Okay, but that is not the case. Okay, so this is a sample employee dashboard. Okay, the information related to the employees, related to the department, the designation, the name of the employee, whether that employee is active or inactive. What is the compensation related data, the information related to that employee, whether the gender is male or female, okay, date of joining, date of birth, retirement. Okay. I've taken some of the data here just to showcase the sample, how it can be done. Okay. It depends upon your information, what is the information you can require. You just need to drag and drop the information. So that is the pull factor that will be worked. We will be designing the entire control sheet for this. And then this information is coming from the control sheet. Okay. Now this how will we will be designing the control sheet, and because the function of working of the dashboard is just to display, but that display will be on the basis of some information. That information need to come from a control sheet, because we cannot link the dashboard directly to the master data or the data employee database. So what we need is to do is to work on the control sheet. So control the information that are required for the dashboard, the master will be getting from the master database or the master data or the employee database through the control sheet. Okay, so we have got a employee dashboard here, so we can just put up a scroll bar here. And on the basis of that scroll bar, we can just select the employee ID and we can see whether that it is changing. So we have got the behavioral skills here and the technical skills here. Okay. So that is the different competencies. So whether what is the required, again, I'm saying it's a dummy data. So don't go on the basis of graphs. Okay, the graphs can distract yourself. But on an average, we can see that if say, for example, this is the required and the color is showing as present of the competency level of competences. Okay. This is a dummy data, so you can expect that there should not be value difference of 3. Okay, so what kind of training that person has done, what kind, so all the information related to that is there in the master database or the employee database. All we need is to have a connection sheet that will be pulling all those data from the HR, the employee database, and giving us the information in our dashboard. Okay, so whether that employees are basically active, inactive. Okay, so if this employees is inactive, let's see if we have some employees in just a dummy data. We have got it active. So we have the employee name. Okay, and showing as whether the person is active. Okay, now who is the head of department? What is the age of the employees? What is the confirmation status? Okay, and what is the flight rate? Okay. So the flight rate here we see that we are in case of graphical representation, we know that 17 people are there with a very high flight rate. And then also in the case of our employee, we can have the flight rate that is mentioned here. Okay. So we on the basis, and then we can use the conditional formatting to see if it is considerable. It will be normal color. If it will be, you know, very high, it will be red in color. So that it, whenever we move from one employee to other employees, we can we are able to see what is the status of the you know, the employee's flight rate. On the basis of the employee's flight rate, we can work on that. So there are behavioral competencies, technical competencies, compensation related, whether there is you know, male or female, where, what is the HOD, name of the employees, department, designation, date of joining. So all the information related to an employees are there in the employee database. Okay. So basically what we see, you can see that graphical dashboard or the HR dashboard, and then we have got the employee dashboard that need to be connected with to through a particular control sheet and making it a totally a dynamic. Now we see that whenever we are changing the, you know, the employee ID, all the information related to that employees are changing. Okay, so we have got employee number 183. So we see that this person is from the commercial department, and accordingly the you know, the competencies are also changing. Okay, so we have this is inactive, so we do not need to consider about the flight rate. When it is the employees is active, then we need to consider concentrate on their your flight rate. Okay, so it's a active employee and the flight rate is considerable. The person is from the electrical department and is a senior supervisor. The age is there. Okay, so we can understand that, yes, from the age how much is left, then we have the date of retirement. So we can plan our succession plan accordingly. So this is an overview of you know, the entire HR dashboard that we make, and we are making a dynamic HR dashboard. Okay, say for example, if your boss if it is 2021, okay, so now we see that there is no information coming here. Okay, this has been intentionally put. You can connect a similar kind of you know, the charts related to compensation. So this is more of a, you know, static, but this is updating themselves. Okay, and then you can also this is the way how you make it a dynamic year by year. Okay, so if you are looking for the information year by year related to compensation, you can make this kind of connection. Or if you are looking forward for only one, then you can make. So basically there are different ways of representing. If you are looking for a particular year only or current year only, then it can be a current year only. Or if you are looking forward for information related to different year, then we can put. Okay, so 2020, this is the status. And for 2019, this is the status. Yeah, so in 2018, this is the status. But when we are talking about 2021, it's totally a blank here. Okay, now why reason is it is totally a blank here? Okay, because the 2021 has not yet started. Now it's whenever the 2021 will come, it will start doing the work itself. Okay, now that is what it is called as the dynamic dashboard, continuously upgrading itself. Okay, and at the same time, it's a real-time data that is displaying. Okay, so whenever there is a change in the employee, everything in the entire calculation gets updated in itself. So let's continue with this, and we will be discussing about the different ways understanding the data, dummy data, and then we will be starting how to work on that step-by-step process in the different sections.